Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Abdullah Patel English High School and DRT Junior College. Let's start by our subject English. Today we are going to start by Unit 3.4, that is Statement of Purpose, Writing Skill, Icebreakers, Explanation of the writing skill of Statement of Purpose, what is Statement of Purpose, and the brainstorming activity. And this we will going to complete by 3.4 today. Okay, so sit straight everyone and listen carefully. Starting by icebreaker, here is the meta column given of the profession. In column A, there is profession has been given to us, and in B column there is the desired qualities, what a profession should be having, the desired professional should have the qualities in them. So the profession over here are given, five profession has been given: businessman, artist, advocate, police and scientist. So the qualities, what qualities should these people should have, that has been given to us and we have to match. Okay, so moving further with the answer without wasting time. Businessman, what a quality should he having? Convincing, selling, risk taking. Second, artist. Artist should have, what artist should have? Imaginative, creative, thinking out of box, right? Third, advocate. Logical reasoning, oratory, critical thinking. Police. Police should be alert, investigative, love for physical activity. Fifth, scientist. Scientist should have what qualities? About reading, experimenting, researching. So here we completed by the method column. The next question is, what is your career goal? So you can write, my career goal is to improve my communication skill, earn, select a suitable career based on my aptitude and rise the rung of the ladder in my chosen career path. Or you can write like, my career goal is to be a doctor, or be a teacher, or be an engineer, or be a CA. Okay, depend on what you want to be. So you can write down in your book. Then the next question is, which of your qualities would help you in achieving your career goals? Okay, so here you can write like this. In your textbook it is given like this, so you can write it in the flow chart. Sense of diagnosis, humanitarian view, positive outlook, perseverance, personal discipline, believe in teamwork, healthy physique, interest in medicine, okay. List your obstacle which might hamper in achieving your goal in life. One is done for you in your textbook. Lack of proper guidance, different views about career, unavailability of information about career, lack of facilities and training centers. Now starting by our section of writing skill, 3.4, Statement of Purpose. By mistake it has written over here section 4, it is section 3, writing skills, 3.4, Statement of Purpose. Now what is Statement of Purpose? A Statement of Purpose, in short we can write as SOP, is an application made to a university to seek admission to a particular course. Means when you are clearing your 12th standard and you are moving for your higher education, over there you are seeking means obtaining admission. You want to take admission to a particular course further. Okay, so at the time you are writing in an application, so that application is called a statement of purpose. Okay, so I hope you understand what is statement of purpose. Moving further, points to be remember of this, that how we have to write is, it is an essay which describe you as a person, your aims and ambitions. This thing should be included about yourself while you are writing an application for the university. It speak about your journey of life and the qualities you have nurtured in the process. The scorecard or the transcript gives your academic achievement, what you have achieved in which things you have taken part. Then the SOP, that is statement of purpose, gives you an opportunity to show the special qualities which make you distinct from others. What is the qualities that make you different from the other? The statement of purpose for undergraduate, postgraduate and doctorate level would be different. The SOPs differ according to the requirement. At this level, when you would pass your standard 12 examination and write personal statement to university for admission to undergraduate course, you should follow the format given over here. Okay, now what is the format? The format of statement of purpose is, the statement of purpose should be written in around 500 words, tentatively in 5 to 6 paragraphs. Okay, so that will be the main thing. Now how it has, it should be written. First, begin with your introduction. Your introduction, like, talk about your personal background, your mental makeup and your aim in life. What is your aim in life? Second paragraph, which consists of that, you should speak about what you wish to join this specific program, course, your area of interest. Then third, in the third paragraph, you can write like about your qualities that would be helpful or suitable for this career, that the thing you have choose goal or the objective of your life. You can show your hobbies and extracurricular activities that will help in strengthening your goals. Fourth paragraph, you can mention about your experience in this field or any internship you have done, project you have done. You can state something which make you distinct from other applicants. And in the fifth and in the concluding paragraph, you can write, state how admission to this particular course, university, would be beneficial to you and how you look at it from the long-term career perspective. We can write a statement of purpose in clear and lucid language. Lucid language means in the simple language. Okay. Now here some detailed format of the statement of purpose has been given to us. That while you begin your introduction, you have to talk about your personal background, your mental makeup and your aim in life. So here is a statement of purpose. Ever since childhood, the function of the economy has fascinated me. I love being able to understand and use economic theories and enjoy challenging myself to find connection between a different sector. I have been captivated by the way this subject is applied in everyday life. In the most basic of ways, for example, deciding that brand of milk to buy and how it can also influence something as major as the exchange rate. Living in India, I am no stranger to economic problems like unemployment and poverty. By increasing my knowledge in the subject, I hope to be better understand these problems. So this is the kind of introduction you can give for yourself. Then the second paragraph, you can speak about your wish to join this specific program, course, your area of interest. So how you can write? So second paragraph can be start like, I aspire to study economics principally because of the diversity of both the subject and its application and because I find it fascinating and challenging at the same time. Having studied the same subject throughout my high school, I believe that the possible depths to which it may be studied are almost endless and the number of real life situations to which it is relevant is similarly vast. In addition to keeping abreast with the world economy, I am also interested in studying the curricular fields of economics and I aspire to further study the ideas of behavioral economics and rational decision making to contribute to improving our explanation of market events. A book that really intrigued me is Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman and intensified my desire to do in the field. Okay, so this is the second paragraph. You can write like this in second paragraph. Third paragraph, you can write about your qualities, what would be helpful, about your goal, about your hobbies, extracurricular activity that you have taken, participated in your school section or in your junior college section. Okay, So third paragraph can be written as, to further understand the practical application of economics, I interned at an auditing firm. This helped me realize how economics and finance play a key role in running a business. My subject choice of economics and accounts to junior college has helped me grasp analytical concept at a blistering pace, and I believe I am well equipped to face the challenge of studying economics at degree level. I'm aware that economics is strongly related to math, and for that reason, I have studied more rigorous topics that I will further develop at a university level, including calculus and statistics modules. Moving further to the fourth paragraph, what you will mention? You will mention your experience in this field, internship if you have attained, or any project you have made, okay, that make you something different from the other student. So the fourth paragraph will be start like, one of the extracurricular activities that opened me to a whole new perspective on world economy was the Indian Model United Nations Conference, in which I was the press corps writer assigned to the economic committee. This has helped me understand the intricacies of world economy, given me a chance to discuss and puzzle over economic issues, and challenge me to think in ways I have never before. So this is the way you are going to write your fourth paragraph. Moving further to the fifth paragraph, you will write like, state how admission to this particular course university would be beneficial to you, and how you look at it from a long-term career perspective, any other research work and achievement in this subject. So you are going to write like, my passion for writing led me to secure the position of sub-editor of the school magazine committee, where I reviewed an edited essay to be published. I was selected as a student council representative, and my duties involved acting as an interface between the student and the board of governors, voting for the issue faced by students and working towards solution for them. I also took part in the Youth Icon Award. I was identified as an important member of my group and performed the task of successfully guiding my team through many leads. So this is the way you are going to write about yourself, that what tasks you have handled at your school or your junior college level. Okay, so that means you are capable of doing or handling the situations. Next is the sixth paragraph, that will be final note mentioning how their graduate program helped you and professor whom you want to work under, and how their research interests incline with yours, and thank them for considering your application. Remember again that whatever you are writing in the statement of purpose, it should be clear, written clear language and in a lucid language, you know, simple language. So say the sixth paragraph, the end, last conclusion paragraph will be like, I enjoy playing badminton as often as I can. Badminton has taught me a vital lesson to face the consequences of a poor shot. I have learned not to dwell on my mistake, but to accept them and move on, because the most important shot in badminton is the next one. I am an amateur guitarist. Music helps me relax and unwind. So this will be the end of your statement of purpose. Okay, six paragraph you have to write. Seventh one, I firmly believe that the analytical tools from the field of economics and mathematics are essential for a deep understanding of the world. I know that the university in Delhi, with their fantastic economic department, can help me realize my dream of simplifying the complexity behind economic situation. So the seventh paragraph will be the paragraph of in any program we are giving vote of thanks, right? So your seventh paragraph is like that, buttering. The key points to remember, see again, that is a quick revision of statement of purpose, that what we have to remember while writing statement of purpose. Okay, so in first paragraph we have to remember that we have to write our introduction and about industry introduction, and letting them know that you, what you want to pursue a graduate major. Second paragraph, introduction to understand about the undergraduate and how it improves your skill, and mentioning your academic and your background which made you pursue this major. Third paragraph about your academic project that you have taken part. Fourth paragraph will be about your internship that you have done. Fifth paragraph about any research work you have done or any achievements are there that you have achieved or in extracurricular activity. Sixth paragraph will include a final note mentioning how the graduate program helped you and professor whom you want to work under and how their research interest inclined with yours, and thank them for considering your application. Now, certain tips are there for writing the statement of purpose. First, it put yourself on the page, means your personality should be seen on the page. Before writing, think and rethink about statement of purpose, that what kind of sentence you are going to make, how you are going to attract the reader who is going to read your statement of purpose. Think from the perspective of university, how the university is going to take your whatever you are writing in the statement of purpose. Write all this thing in a fluent manner. Keep your writing simple and interactive. Collect all the information about course, university, and it should reflect in your statement of purpose. Just think that which question that university will ask. Try to give the answer in your own language. Your statement of purpose should reflect your work and personality. Show your interest in this course program. Edit, re-edit, read, re-read, write, rewrite. Statement of purpose should be simple and grammatically correct. Whatever you do, edit, re-edit, read, reread, write, rewrite, but your statement of purpose should be written in a simple, lucid manner and without any grammatical mistake. Okay, because you are applying for degree college, for your degree course, so here your grammatical mistakes are not avoidable. Okay, moving further to the solve example of statement of purpose, that is the brainstorming activity A3 and A4. Here is the match the column about the job terms with their meaning. To be your own boss, a dead end job, a good team player. So likewise 10 are there, so your meaning you have to match it down. So I have done for you, take a screenshot and write down in your English notebook. To be your own boss, answer is to have your own business. A dead end job means a job with no promotional opportunities. Third, a good team player means someone who can work well with other people. Fourth, a heavy workload, answer is to have a lot of work to do. A high powered job means an important, powerful job. Sixth, job satisfaction means where you can enjoying your job. Seventh, manual work means work that requires physical activity. Eighth, to be stuck in a rut, answer is to be in a boring job that is hard to leave. Nine, to be stuck behind a desk means to be unhappy in an office job. Tenth, a 9-to-5 job means a normal job having a duty of 8 hours. Then A4, activity A4, read the dialogue given below and fill in the blanks with the appropriate job terms given above. So here is the dialogues given. Varsha, Vivek, what kind of job are you looking for? Vivek, Varsha, I want to be my own boss. I don't like a 9-to-5 job. My present job is not challenging. I'm stuck behind a desk. I'm not afraid of a heavy workload and I am a good team player. Moreover, this is a dead end job. I'm looking for an opportunity to try new wins. So here you can see some points are highlighted. Okay, so these are the point that we have seen in the match the column. So we are going to take help and moving further by this. Here we have completed by statement of purpose. I hope you have understand statement of purpose. Listen it again and again. So I hope you are going to understand it. It is very easy. Okay. Nothing hard is there that you cannot understand. Read a chapter twice. so your doubt will be clear. If still there is any doubt, you can clear out with me. So till then, stay at home, stay safe. Thank you so much for listening my video.